What's up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog. Sorry I haven't been as active as I would like with the vlogs, but today we're actually doing another shoot with a very special car. We're heading down to Miami.
I picked up that boy Andre, repping that BAM.
Oh, sorry.
No, you good.
All right, we're getting some breakfast right now. It's kind of early, and then we have to be in Miami around like 10:30. So I'm gonna take you guys along and show you kind of the new setup that I'm running. And yeah, so we'll see you guys there.
Right now, we're heading up to the roof of the Miami Museum Garage, which is located in the Art District, Miami Art District. I've shot some promo stuff here before, but never really like a full-on feature video. It's pretty cool because it's very colorful up there, and then we're here a little bit early, probably like an hour early actually. I'm gonna set up the drone and get some nice shots of like Miami. And yeah, it looks like it's a cloudy day, but it's not gonna rain. So yeah, look at this, guys. So we're here at the rooftop of the Miami Museum Garage. Look how colorful it is. I'm sure you guys have seen it. If you guys are interested in actually, if you're in the area and interested in finding this place and coming up here and shoot for yourself, I'm actually going to link the address down below so you guys can come and create your own visuals here. But we're working with a cloudy day, so it's actually pretty nice. Right now I have the DJI Mavic, the first one. I'm gonna just get some drone shots because we're here a little bit early, get some nice B-roll going. And then I'm gonna walk you guys through my, some new equipment that I have and just how I'm gonna set up for today's shoot. So let's go. Guys, so the drone shots have been completed. Now I just remembered I got a really nice 70 to 200 telephoto lens. I'm gonna set it up on sticks right there and get some B-roll of like the big buildings and stuff. We get real close, so I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of how that goes down. So right now I'm taking off the little mounting plate for my Ronin M. Which, surprisingly, if you have I have a Ronin M and a Ronin S that I recently bought, and this thing is too, the little mounting plate for the Ronin M doesn't work for the Ronin S and vice versa. So unfortunately, I'm gonna have to switch. But the good news is, my Manfrotto video head mount here, it works for both the tripod and also the Ronin S, so it's pretty cool. The more you know.
Ding, 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 ding.
That's shooting stuff. All right, I want to show you guys. I recently got the new, well, it's not new anymore. It's been out for a little while, but the Ninja 5, it's a lot smaller. It only takes one battery, and it still takes the same SSDs that I had before. So I'm kind of retiring the Ninja Flame for a little while because this one's actually it's a lot smaller, it's still brighter, and it just has a lot more built in so that it can record the full, the full ProRes. It can even do ProRes RAW for the A7S III, which, surprise, I upgraded a new camera here. It's pretty cool. Take this out. The last video you saw with the, I think it was the C10, the last video on my channel, that's the first video I did with this camera. And I'm really happy with it. I'm still learning S-Log 3 and how to color grade it, but I like to just get my feet wet and just try it out. So it's been pretty good so far. Right now I'm gonna go over there to the edge and get some shots. So let's do it, guys. So this shot is really nice right here. I am on the 70 to 200 F4 Zeiss lens,
recording. If anyone's out there shooting A7S3, I'll kind of share kind of my the settings that I'm running. I'm actually shooting 420, 4K 24 frames per second for this shot in S-Log 3. So in the codec, the HS codec. I did some tests and the HS seems to be the best to run on my computer that I used to edit. So I want to make the process easier for me when I'm editing. And then hopefully next year I'm going to upgrade to a better system so I can get probably the full capabilities out of this camera. But yeah, on the HS it works perfectly. I'm going to shoot some 4K slow-mo as well as 4K 60. I don't know if I'll need 4K 120, but hey, now we have the option to do that with the Sony A7S3. But just grabbing some B-roll shots, as you can see. I don't know if you could bring the GoPro closer. You see I'm getting a nice shot of that bridge out there. Yeah, looking real nice. And yeah, it's a beautiful day.
Oh man.
Sorry. So the way the sun's coming in right now, we're gonna use the little hood here, lens hood. Hopefully black out some of that. Let's see if that makes a difference. A little bit. I'm just grabbing this building over there. It looks cool. So I just did some more B-roll with the telephoto lens. And right now I'm talking to Ant. You're gonna see Anthony's car. It's a very clean Scion TC. I've had it for a long time and this shoot is very well overdue. But right now I have set up a shot, a tight shot. So as soon as he comes to the side of the roof, the garage, we'll be able to see him. So right now I'm telling him to come on up. And somebody's walking across the frame.
Guys,
shout out Far From Basic crew, one of the OG crews that I remember here in South Florida. All their cars are always on point, very family oriented, right?
Very well, yeah. For a small crew, so right now we have about 12 heads.
Okay,
and it's just a family ambiance. So we barbecue together, we hang out together, we shoot cars together.
So that's what it's all about. I know there's a lot of crews, you know, out there in like the US and different areas, so it's always nice to enjoy the culture and also enjoy the people that you're hanging out with. But today we're shooting his back TC here. I've always seen it at shows, but I've never had the opportunity to shoot it. So I'm gonna add my little magic touch and it's gonna look awesome. I'm excited for today's shoot. Let's do it. Thank you, Andre. Now I'm doing like some nice glamour shots with the model and we're doing actually we're testing out 4K 120, so we're gonna slow it down extra nice, make it more nice. Cinematic, speed up, slow down, it's gonna look real nice. And I just got kind of the back of a shirt, which by the way, this is artwork, guys. I'm gonna tag you. I know you still have your page, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna tag his page, you guys go check him out.
Thank you.
And if you guys need any graphic work done, boom, there you go.
Nice. Get him up.
Somewhat clean.
Yeah, but ideas, Andre, ideas for you.
Well, now I know why it sounds like this. I'm like, oh.
Look at all the carbon.
It's not just for looks.
Ceramic coat, your headers, bro. So they've been on my car for 6 years.
Yeah, bro.
There's a battery under there?
Right here.
So for the back and for the sound system, I had to do an additional battery.
Okay, so it's just chilling there.
And then, well.
Shout out Slammer.
Video of Danny's hand going through my trunk, and he cut a hole in the trunk. He built,
knocked out some shots with the Ronin M and the 24-70. So right now I'm putting the 24-70 away, F4, and I'm grabbing my wide angle, which I think I have talked to a few people about it. This is the Tamron 17-28. I would say a very affordable piece of glass. Autofocus is great for Sony cameras, and I believe they make different variations for different cameras, but this is the E-mount one, and it's a really good lens for, like I said, wide angle shots. So I'm switching out this lens right here, and I'm gonna throw it on the Ronin S, which, by the way, now I have a Ronin S, and it's gonna be huge. It's a good system. I got it for a very good price, so I couldn't pass it up. I do know the Ronin S2 came out recently, and that one looks sick, but I think I'm gonna rock with this one for a while and get the hang of it.
Yeah.
All right, we're in the van now, guys. We had a little bit of technical difficulties with the GoPro, but we got her back up and running. As you can see right here on my lap, we have the Ronin S in the upside down configuration. I believe they call this the briefcase mode. I put these handles backward, I guess backwards or upside down, so I get more of like a Ronin M feel. The monitor, the Ninja 5, I have set up right here, and the camera's down there. So we're just waiting to get on like a bridge, and doors off. When I say doors off, Andre knows. Doors come off, I manually open this side door, and then I start shooting. Sneak peek, guys, off the Ninja 5, shooting all internally onto the Sony A7S III. I'm not doing external today, but I can't wait to grade this 10-bit. It's gonna look sick. Right now we're following him to the last location. Grab a couple last shots there, and that should be it for the shoot. I'm gonna take Mr. Andre to this little pizza spot.
Yes.
That Mr. Mike reminded me of on Wednesday, this last Wednesday, and get some food and then head back to West Palm, guys. Look at that. It's been a great day here. Ooh. All right, we rolling?
Yes, sir.
All right, we just wrapped up the shoot with Anthony. He's heading home. We ended up at this spot right behind Bayfront Park. I never thought it was over here. And look, there's a Ferris wheel here now. And oh yeah, he's over there airing up, airing down. Grabbing the shot. This shot would be cool, but yeah, we just wrapped up the shoot, guys. I put everything away. I want to make sure my HDMI is in here because I had it around my neck, but I don't know where it's at. So right now I'm gonna take Mr. Andre. We're gonna go grab some lunch, and yeah, it was a great day. Thank you guys for coming along behind the scenes, and until the next feature video, which hopefully will be in a week from now, I'll see you guys there. Have a nice day, guys.